Good evening. In this video, I'll talk about introduction of dynamic conditional correlation, and that is very famous in terms of DCC. DCC is a part of GARCH. That's why it is also known as DCC GARCH. Hence, DCC GARCH is applied to capture the degree of volatility correlation changes or a spillover between two or more than two variables. The integration of the market is depicted by conditional correlation in movement, which is time varying in nature. It has been propounded by Engel in 2002 to capture the dynamic correlation of returns. This model is expressed as ST equal to dt rt dt. In this given equation, ST is denoted as the estimator of conditional correlation, and dt may be expressed as diagonal of h1t, it means that is root under t, and so on. Dt is also known as conditional standard deviation, which is n by n diagonal matrix and extracted from GARCH, whereas RT is the conditional correlation. RT is presented as QT to the power minus 1, QT and again QT to the power minus 1, where QT is expressed as 1 minus B T minus T to the power T minus 1 and QT minus 1, which is unconditional covariance matrix of the standardized errors or standardized residuals that can be depicted as covariance of T to the power capital T. The significance of ADCC and BDCC. Basically, when you talk about DCC, that helps you to examine the spillover or transmission of information from maybe one market to another market, or maybe one series to another series. So when you apply DCC, we get alpha DCC and beta DCC. So in this slide, we talk about what does it mean by alpha DCC and beta DCC. The significance of ADCC and BDCC implies that the estimators obtained in the DCC MGARS are dynamic and time varying. ADCC measures the short-run volatility impact, which means that the persistency of the standardized residuals from the previous period. Similarly, BDCC measures the lingering effect of a shock impact on the conditional correlations, which is the persistence of the conditional correlation process. It means ADCC is nothing but alpha DCC, and this alpha DCC examine the spillover or transmission of information from one market to another or one series to another for short run or for short period of time, whereas beta DCC measures the long run spillover or long run transmission of information. The sum of the DCC alpha and DCC beta are less than 1, which indicates that conditional correlation in the models are not constant over the time. In case summation of DCC alpha and DCC beta becomes 1 or maybe greater than 1, then we go for the asymmetrical GARCH. So that is all about introduction of dynamic conditional correlation. I hope you like it. Thank you very much.